Ready to call the meeting to order. This is a regular scheduled meeting of the Marvin City Council. Today is Tuesday, the 13th, June 17th. Will you call for the order?
Councilmember Warren.
Here.
Councilmember Smith.
Present.
Councilmember Henderson.
Here.
Councilmember McDavid.
Here.
Councilmember Byrd.
Here.
Mayor Pro Tim Porter.
Here.
Mayor Kimper.
Here. Certified posting?
Posting was done in accordance with the open meeting.
We'll stand for the pledge and invocation. Mr. Slaughter.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Our Heavenly Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for this day that you've allowed us to see. We thank you, Lord, for the gift of life. As we go forward in this meeting, we pray, Lord, that it will be a productive meeting and that the good of the city, Lord, will be served. Lord, we want to thank you for the blessings that you bestowed upon us. And we just pray and ask that you will continue to look down and bless the city of Marvin. It's in your Son, Christ Jesus, I pray and give thanks. Amen.
Amen.
One citizen input. Brenda Clay. You'll be limited to 3 minutes for a city-related issue. Please state your name and address. You can address the council. The council will not be allowed to respond or answer questions.
I'm long for 63 years. And I was under the council member, Mrs. Scotty Henderson, for 30 of those years. And due to the lack of the city neglecting the resident, I moved from that resident. And it wasn't because Councilman Henderson didn't try and help me. He did. When he researched the situation, this had been over 30-some years, and I drove by those houses, and they're still overgrown. He told me that the city told him, as long as the person was paying their tax, that it was nothing that they could do to them about the property. That was back then. So we just wrote that off as being ignorant because we knew that something could have been done. But what the citizens have to realize is that one council member is only one vote. One of my concerns today is over the late water bill issue. And I did go through the chain of command. I talked to the clerk, and she told me that it wasn't their fault that the bill was mailed out on the 5th. I went in, I asked to speak to the city manager. The city manager told me that they wasn't at fault because the bill was mailed out. I feel like Marlin is all our fault. We have senior citizens in this town that only receive $700 and some a month. When it was reported here, this is not the first time this had happened. When it was reported here, why someone didn't talk with the postmaster to see where did those water bills go? I thank God that I was able to pay both of my bills at my residence and at my shop. But everybody's not able to do that. We have senior citizens that are strictly waiting on their bill because they want their receipt. You all understand. You have older parents, older people that you're overseeing. They do not understand that they won't have a receipt if they don't wait for their bills. So I asked the city manager if there was any way that a bill could go out, our bill, or a letter. I was told, well, they was the same ones that mailed the water bills. Okay, that might be true. But then I think that if it's an issue, then you should work with that person. I worked for the VA for 20-some years. They lost our checks one time and mailed them to my help. I was city manager to one of the vehicles and went over and got our checks, because those checks was gonna have to be routed to Dallas, back to Waco, and then to Marvin. Councilman Henderson's father was working there at that time. He knows the truth. Another thing, our bill states that we pay for a chipper service. Why do we have to call for a service person to come out and pick up off of the lawn where debris is laying there for a chipper service when we pay for it? Why do we have to beg you to come down and fill these holes up where you have residents living here? Why do we have to stay on that phone and ask you, will you please send a truck out to fill these holes up for our cars? I have a busted strut because I drive a little Ford Focus. And I've been told to bring everything in and the city can see what they can do about it. But why should I go get the strut fixed when you're not keeping up with the holes? I feel like if you have a city vehicle that's moving around in this city and you don't know where that truck is, just like the policemen have to park these new vehicles here, if I don't have you on assignment, you need to bring that truck back to the barn, because we got enough holes to fill up to keep you busy. And another thing is this is the worst sanitation service that I've ever seen in my life. And if you report them, they leave your trash can out in the street and they half dump it. I don't know when their contract is gonna be up, but I feel that our city, it's time to stop bickering over nonsense and give the citizens of this Falls County of Marvin some respect. Thank you.
I move that we approve the minutes from April 11th, May 1st, and May 9th.
Second.
Motion's been made and seconded. Any other further discussion? Will you call for the vote?
Councilmember Moore?
Yes.
Councilmember Smith?
Yes.
Councilmember Henderson?
Yes.
Councilmember McDavid?
Yes.
Councilmember Byrd?
Abstain.
Mayor Pro Tem Porter?
Yes.
Mayor Nelson?
Yes.
I'm sorry.
I can't get that high. Number seven, here project updates, reports from MBR Gray.
MRBA, representing from MRB Gray has not been able to make it.
Okay.
Eight, discussion and action on ordinance number 17-010, restricting vehicular traffic as defined in ordinance.
What is the wish of the council?
Make a motion we approve ordinance 17-010, restricting vehicular traffic as defined in the ordinance.
Second.
A motion is made and seconded. Any further discussion?
I think we need to point out that this is a result of TCEQ. A lot of people like to go out to Lake Pratt ATVs, but the problem is there's a lot of damage being done to the dam. And worse than that, they've already told us 5 or 6 times, they've written us up, told us quit, quit, quit. Well, now that TCEQ has gone to TCEQ instead of the dam inspection area, that TCEQ has finding authority. And we already know that they have a big stick and they will swing it at us if we don't take action. In addition to that, it's a homeland security requirement that dams and drinking water be closed off to the public. So for that reason is why this ordinance is being published and put forward.
Any further discussion?
Yes, I'd just like to ask a question. The ordinance was already at the lights. We need to rename it. You just redefining it. What's the difference?
I would assume that we're modifying it to be more defined as far as what is included.
Right.
Because I think the other one we have is very vague.
Okay, so it's just been modified a little bit?
Correct.
Yes, my understanding, fishing will still be allowed and all that stuff, right?
Yes.
Okay.
The only thing that's going to be blocked off is past the airport, there's a dirt road that goes back there that everybody, the only was accessible for a long time was with ATVs. Well, we've had to cut that road all the way back out, do a little bit better job than it was, because we have to clear the old dam. All the trees have to be cut down. And that work, they're working that little as they can. We just don't have the resources to do it all at once. But that's the reason that road goes all the way back there. And they're going to put, in fact, gates already up, post already set and all, right there at the airport. The same thing's being done at the burn pile. TCEQ has written that up. That's being closed off. So all these are at the requirements of TCEQ. But to get to the lake, piece of cake, go just like you always went. You can get to the park. It's all open. Boat ramps are open. So we're not preventing anybody, we're not keeping anybody from fishing.
Any further discussion? Will you call for the vote?
Councilmember Warren?
Yes.
Councilmember Smith?
Yes.
Councilmember Henderson?
Yes.
Councilmember Davis?
Yes.
Councilmember Byrd?
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Ward?
Yes.
Mayor Cooper?
Yes. Number nine.
Discussion and action on ordinance number 17-009, charter amendment for council term limits.
What is the wish of the council?
I make a motion to accept the ordinance. After reading it, do we have any choice?
Motion has been made and seconded. Any further discussion?
I need a second. You have a second.
Terrence?
Thank you.
Since then, we call for the vote?
Councilmember Warren?
Yes.
Councilmember Smith?
Yes.
Councilmember Henderson?
Yes.
Councilmember McDavid?
Yes.
Councilmember Byrd?
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Ward?
Yes.
Mayor Cooper?
Yes.
I'll start this ballroom. We need to repair the roof, but we don't need to borrow any money.
We can't borrow from ourselves to pay back?
We could borrow from ourselves. But as far as going on the outside and the city taking out another loan, I'm strictly against that. Every time we take out a loan, it's got to be passed on to the citizens. And I just don't think that we need to find a way to do this with what we have. And I think we can do that. It's just we need to sit down and figure out how it is without borrowing money.
Do we know how much the bids were?
It was in a packet, I think, before you came to council.
Yeah.
I think it was.
But it may have already been approved. It's been approved.
Correct.
It's already been approved. We do have some funds in the first rate that would be enough, more than enough, to handle covering this cost, and it would be us borrowing from ourselves. And therefore, we wouldn't be paying any interest. We'd just be paying back ourselves.
Now, would that bring up?
And that would be my recommendation, that we use those funds.
What was the source of those funds? I'm sorry, I didn't hear.
Do the what?
What was the source of the funds? You said First Street?
First Street. It's part of the money that's been sitting there for a lot of years. It's quasi under the general fund, but it's an independent fund that we would pay back.
And how long would that take? Well, there's a lot of work still on First Street that needs to be done.
There's a lot of work that needs to be done on lots of streets.
Yes, but First Street is a drainage problem.
Yeah.
That's the biggest drainage problem in all of them.
And we're going to be looking for grants. grants to dealing with drainage through the city. The city's had drainage programs, I have yet to see one. Signed, I've been told what it was, et cetera, but I haven't seen it. And we're working on getting grant help with the drainage program. But in reality, a drainage program's also going to go along between streets because they go hand in hand, because drainage involves using a lot of the curb and gutter, et cetera, and pipes at the intersections, and then where it goes. But that's something that I won't come to you about until we take care of what's under the streets, which is making sure that the sewer system and the water system are up to standard and meeting all of TCEQ requirements that way, which right now we don't.
Now, when we got the estimate for the roof to be fixed, did we have anything in there as far as the mold is growing in different areas of City Hall itself? Mayor's office, secretary's office. Did any of that include?
What we're going to do for the mold is, like my office, and it does have black mold on the tile, all those tiles like these will come down. All the insulation will come out over that office and over the areas where we have that problems. If there's any mold that they can see, that will be treated with a bleach water mixture to kill it and do that. And that will be done by Public Works. And then the tiles and the insulation and tiles replaced.
But there's not any cost of the repair of the roof itself?
We're not getting anybody else to do it. We can handle that in-house. But it's something that needs to be done. The roofs need to be repaired because there are, to my knowledge, two places with black mold. One's in my office and the other one's in the conference room right next to my office.
And the secretary's office.
I have a question, a couple of this. One would be, there's no other place we can look to find these funds?
No.
Okay. My biggest thing about doing the roof versus getting the money from the vote on first reading is, if sewer is running on the street, we got 900 problems now that are just the drainage. And the first thing we're going to do is take those funds, so we're going to go fix the roof on the building. Well, we should have spent these funds a long time ago fixing and correcting those problems. I think we really need to look somewhere else to get those funds to do that. We have the engineers right now that are looking into those problems that's down there on First Street. That money's been there a while, but it should have been there and corrected the problems that exist down there. But as soon as we got a problem on the roof, then we're going to get the money and go do what we need to do. I think you need to look elsewhere. I'm against going there and getting a loan for it. I think we need to look elsewhere. There's got to be something we can do other than all that money to take care of those problems down there. So that was earmarked money by a grant. Also, folks can get that work done. And they got sued to take that money and repair First Street. Now we're going to use that money to fix the roof. If I remember correctly, that was for because they didn't repair those streets and things correctly down there, and the water's in the street. Then we were supposed to take the money that they got for, and this is the money we're talking about, right? I know it is. Anyway, ask that question. That's the money. Now that money, those people didn't do the job with that money. That money been there quite a few years. They were supposed to be down there and already taking care of that problem. Now that it had taken care of that problem, we're going to take it and fix the roof immediately. I think that would be wrong. But, you know, I'm with just one person on this council. I think you'd be wrong to borrow that money when you should have corrected those problems and you already sued somebody to correct those problems. Those problems still exist.
All that's going to happen, Councilman, is that if we don't borrow, take it from ourselves, we're going to have to go to the bank and borrow, pay interest on it. Because the longer we go without these roofs being repaired, the more damage that is going to be done from the mold, et cetera, and from leaking. And it won't be Public Works that will be able to take, fix those problems. We'll be spending more money, or we'll be kicked out of the building while we're repairing the mold problem and cleaning it up.
How long it gonna be before we can put this money back?
The contractor would probably start within the next week or so. They were wanting to start before that, but said, hey, we don't have a way to pay for it yet. And had to hold them off so they would get this.
That's it, and answer the question. How long it's gonna take to put this money back in that $80,000?
Oh, put the money back in it? We're talking about 3 years. Possibly sooner.
How long have we had it?
It's been there for at least 12.
Well, I think that's one of the issues that we've looked at. Mr. Grunstad and I have looked for where we can find the funds. And we're not finding the places other than going to the bank. I agree the funds need to be used for that, and that's why we're structuring it as a loan from ourselves. The issue that I think we're finding is the $80,000 is not going to do anything down there. We need more money. And I know what needs to be done, but if we take $80,000 by the time we get engineers firmed, we're going to have $20,000 to dig up a ditch. And instead of borrowing the money and putting us farther in debt, when we have the money sitting there, yes, it needs to be used, but I think we're to the point that it's been sitting there 12 years and it's not going anywhere. That $80,000 is not going to fix it.
Well, it's far more than just digging the ditches.
I agree.
I mean, you got GCQ can write that place up down there and then what we're going to do, go borrow money to fix that. It should have been something done that $80,000 waiting for now. We have money put aside in the water rehab fund for these same things. And it wasn't supposed to be bought for that water plant. They got their hands in that money. We have none of that water rehab money. It was going into the millions. They found ways that they were going to fix streets. They never got to the streets. They found ways to put the water meters in. Put water meters here, and we end up paying again for water meters. Those funds are gone too. I just cut it short to you. I'm not for messing with that $80,000 other than going out and doing something with First Street with it. I know you do more than big ditches with it. You go down there, and you should have had the engineers that already spent that money a long time ago. When them pipes down there are too small to carry all the homes down there, it's more than just digging a ditch out. You need some engineers to go down there and do some reports. I still say is you've got to be another way you can get the money to fix this roof other than messing with that money for it to be earmarked down there. I don't know how legal it is to go there and get the grant money itself to do that. Because that money was granted for that street. And it was granted there to repair that street. The folk didn't do that properly. They went down there and got sued, but the street fell in. And it was causing a water problems there. But they got sued for the money and really didn't get enough to go down and repair those streets. Now you want to use that money for something else. That's going back way to the history. I guess everybody won't be here, but I'm going to tell you that like I see it, that was there when it happened. It was there when they got sued for it. We should have got way more money in that for those streets. And it probably been taken care of. The money should have been somewhere and getting the interest on it so you can take care of those problems. And it's going to take us 3 years now to go back and readdress that. I think we need to look somewhere else, try to raise some money some other kind of way to repair this roof. We definitely need it. But I hope you take a trip down there when it's raining and the sewer's backing up out those little people's homes down there.
I've been down there.
So, I mean, we got the same problems here. Yeah. We've got those same problems down here. The money is there to do something with it. So I'll be strongly against that, but I just got one vote. I'll leave it right there.
That's up down here. That's up on Old Street. Once it affects that, it affects back up town too, all the way up to Lidle Street. And you get rid of that business, you don't have no business there.
I know in one of our previous meetings, Mr. Porter brought up, using the lawsuit money that we had just received last month. Do we know what the balance is on that?
I emailed it, it's $79,000 something, and I've got $13,500 worth of bills still to pay. Off of that, that's just for April, it doesn't include any invoicing for May or for June.
Hey, what, since we're sitting up here without any balances in front of us, it's pretty hard to make an intelligent decision or give any guidance. Why don't we ask the city manager to go back and look at that with the city secretary? And maybe we can take a little bit from several places, maybe a little bit from one, a little bit from another. If we put it together, we have enough to get this repaired out. And then come up with a short-term payback. Not a three-year or four-year, talking about short-term, a way to pay this back in the short term. And then we'll have that in front of us, we can make a little better decision. It's hard to talk money when we don't have account balances in front of us.
That's just what's happening.
To go with Ms. Perry?
I said account balances are one thing, that's just what we have in the bank as of today. That doesn't have anything to do with our current budget that's already spoken for.
I understand that.
But while we wait, the roof ain't getting no better.
No, it's not.
Correct.
So we're allowing ourselves to have a bigger problem. I admit, First Street is a problem, it's always been a problem. When I was a kid, it was a problem. But we're not gonna dig ourselves a bigger hole by waiting, are we? If we need to do something with this money, we need to move this money 12 years is long enough. If we're gonna pay it back, like you said, maybe we can pay it back 3 years, maybe two, maybe one. Maybe we need to figure out a quicker payback plan. But right now, we need roof.
Give me 1 second.
We have a problem with the budget starting now. And that's gotta be done by September. Everything's in the budget is already there. I'm sure that roof is not included in that budget that we put together. If it was, then it ought to be already repaired. And if it wasn't in that budget, then we knew we weren't gonna have any money for it when it was time to fix this roof. It didn't just go bad. We're getting ready to go through a budget process, June, July, and August. The fiscal year starts over September 1. What do we have? I mean, we got all kinds of people that's laid off and everything else here. We're short in every department. And you need to have a budget workshop to find out what you can do. Or you might go in there to $8,000 again for something. Because it's telling me that funds got to be somewhere and you're going to draw a budget every year. I know you could, if you're going to go and do a budget workshop, you start September 1, that's going to be in your budget. But you can borrow money. There could be some money somewhere that we can borrow from other places too. Like I said, there might be a shorter way that we can come back and pay that money. But we need to have our engineers go down and start doing what they need to do. And that ain't going to be cheap for them to just draw and go down and fix that drainage. And we're going to have to wait 3 years and put it on hold. That's a big decision, but that'd be tough for me to just say we need to go in at $80,000, but they may be another way to maybe do it. I'm probably getting that roof fixed. We need to find a way to get better. I agree with Mr. Porter, I think we need to go back and take a good, strong look, make sure it's not something else we can do before we just grab that money.
Wanted to give you some numbers here before you. The total estimate, which I at this point is not very old, I assume it's still valid. We're at $61,328 for roof repairs. We have an approximate $66,000 left after the invoices that have come in. We don't know exactly what's coming in. I would assume at this point those are the largest, based on my conversations that I've had. Those are going to be the largest invoices we have. My opinion is utilize those funds to do the roof so the roof gets fixed. And the bottom line is if we can't find the funds, we're going to have to borrow the money. My theory is if we get to the point that we, 2 months from now, we have $20,000 worth of invoices coming in, I feel that loan is going to be a lot less than what we're having to borrow to repair the roof. Not that we want to do that, but as Mr. Smith says, we're sitting here every day, it's pouring inside buildings. I mean, the buildings are getting worse and worse and worse. I mean, we have buildings over our records that have water falling in on them. And I think sitting and looking at numbers, which Alan and I have done many times, and these are the proposals that we've come up with based on what we can find, you know, that is another option that we can possibly have, is utilize the funds. It still leaves roughly $5,000 for any outstanding invoices that be coming in. If those invoices come in at $20,000, we've got $5,000, we wouldn't have a choice at that point but to take a loan for $15,000, but at least we're taking it for $15,000 and not for $62,000.
Are we just going to have a settlement with the...
That's what I'm talking about.
Big Creek?
Yeah.
Okay. So we have a settlement there, as I was going to say, that money already spent?
Those are the numbers I'm talking about.
Okay. I thought you were talking about $80,000 money.
We were talking about both.
Okay.
And that would still leave the $80,000 to continue on First Street if we need to.
So you're saying that we could possibly use that $50,000 that we just got in the settlement?
That's 80, but the balance on it right now is...
66,000.
Around 66.
And our roof is going to cost what?
61. That's what I said. It still leaves roughly $5,000 to pay the outstanding invoices that we would have coming in.
You sound like the way to go to me.
We build monthly on Brushy Creek?
Yes.
How much a month, roughly?
We have the other reserve funds for Brushy Creek. The one that's in tax pool. We can get to if we need to.
Okay.
But I've stayed away from that.
Yep.
As much as
possible.
It's also my understanding with the conversation I had with Elizabeth that the largest of the bills have already been issued and paid. There hasn't been much work done. It was basically, at this point, was filing paperwork. And so I think the largest of it has been done and it been billed out.
So you're proposing this as a loan?
Yes.
We'll pay ourselves back.
Over what period
of time? Short time period.
A year or two.
Whatever's not going to hinder us. You know, I think that can be decided. I mean, the city manager can make that decision. I mean, he's going to be looking at the budget to find out what's going to be feasible for us. Obviously, we don't want to strain it, but I mean, I would look at a 3-year term because that's what we're paying now, or that's a proposed loan.
It's lawful for us to make a loan on that.
It's my understanding, yes, that goes back to our general fund. Because we have not been able to find a
specific loan.
I really don't mind how we do it. It's our own money. So, I mean, if we want to charge interest for that particular fund, I mean, that doesn't matter to me either way because it's our money. But I don't see any reason why we would need to charge our self-interest.
Well, you have a loss of use of funds, and since that money deals directly with Big Creek, I would hate to think that we're losing any advantage that we might have
say is it's not earmarked for Big Creek. I mean, that's general funds. I mean, so far that we have found, it has come out of general funds. That's what it was told.
It came out of...
We have a special account?
It came out of Brush Creek Fund. It had to go out of Brush Creek Fund.
Okay. So you have a question to tell me that?
Yeah, I'll go back.
So then, yeah, we need to go back to that fund then. But I think at this point, we need those funds on the roof more than we do.
And the lawyers looked at this and you think he's giving you a pass on doing this?
I actually asked him to be here tonight to help us resolve this issue.
And what did he say?
I think we need to table this. Do we just want to make sure we look in all areas if we possibly can? So we can come up with that $60,000-something to this roof fix. If that $50,000 we use, when you use it, then we're not too far from doing what we need to do. But without the attorney, I think someone that takes a serious look, you're talking about messing with that money that was earmarked for a grant. But I know I'm not a lawyer, but I don't think you can take that earmarked money and do what you want to do with it. Then you have this money that was over in Brush Creek. You don't know if that money's earmarked, you're not supposed to go tampering with it. You better get some facts before we start just dipping off into some things. They can need to table that. We got to get the roof fixed, but make sure we got the proper way of doing it. I don't think the wrong decision for us. Go and get some money earmarked and spend it, and then we're going to regret it later. Because I'm sure I know some folks that's going to definitely check on that money. If they didn't do what they're supposed to do like they're supposed to, I guarantee we're going to hear about it. And I'm not going to be part of that. I think we need to really table it. We got to get this roof fixed. We can't wait a long time. But it's not that we can't have a meeting to come in here and say we got the money to do what we need to do without going either long. I'd like to make a motion to table it until we get that money straight.
A second. Motion's been made and seconded. Is there any further discussion?
I don't know. I'm worried about the roof.
Sorry?
I said I'm worried about the roof. We're not going to get anything done. It's going to get worse. I mean, that's my opinion.
I agree. It's been going on for...
For a long, we waited for a long time, and it needs to be taken care of. That's how I think.
I believe we're at the point where we got to make a decision, and I don't see table it as a decision.
It was a way to pay for it.
We got 12 years of bond we've been holding on to. When we pay them back, we pay them back. But we can't make the problem any worse by letting the roof collapse. If we're going to let it collapse, we might as well move out now and let it fall in. If we're going to fix it, we're going to fix it.
But at the same time, we need to find out if that money's able to move from one spot to another because it's already earmarked as a grant. And grants are something that you just don't play with when you grab them. If that funds are not used for that particular thing, you can be in big trouble.
And paying back that whole thing.
So are we worried about the legal aspects, or are we going to fix the roof? I think the motion should be, let us fix the roof. If we're going to fix the roof, let's fix it. If we're not going to fix it, we need to move on. We're just spinning our wheels.
Senator?
The funds in the First Street Fund are actually proceeds from lawsuits.
That's what I thought.
That were paid back.
That's not part of the grant. That's our money from a lawsuit.
So if that's enough money there, then why don't we fix the roof with that and create the whole thing now?
That was the original.
That's what we were saying.
Yes, sir.
And I'll second.
You already have a motion on the floor that didn't say it first. You also on the floor that didn't say it.
Yep. Any further discussion on that? Would you call for the vote?
Councilmember Moore?
Will you please explain this?
Just clarify.
Sure.
Clarify this, please.
The motion at this point by Mr. Henderson is to table it.
table it until we find where we're gonna get the funds. I just table it and not fix the roof. Let's don't get that, this screwed. You need to know where you're gonna get your money from to fix the roof. I'm not saying don't fix it. But you better know and get clarified where you can get the money from and make sure it's the right money that we can use to do it with. At the same time, look if we can find another place to get the money to do it, other than borrowing.
Mr. Henderson, they just said that that was our money, the $80,000, that that wasn't a grant.
I'm not an attorney.
Okay, what, you're saying the $80,000, is that what's in your Brush Creek budget?
We're talking two different funds.
We're talking two different funds.
One, with the one Mr. Curtis Smith was talking about a while ago.
That $80,000 is for First Street. No, that was.
Yes.
First Street.
They're actually both proceeds from a lawsuit.
So then we're safe to use them? They're ours, we can use it.
The, at this point, my understanding is First Street, yes. Have we, but we haven't confirmed Brush Creek if it can be used for that or not.
I don't know about.
Yeah, that's why we asked him to be here tonight.
But you're sure about using the funds that was gotten for Bobby's grant that was replaced because they didn't get the grant done right?
It wasn't replaced.
Right, that.
That was a straight lawsuit.
A lawsuit because of the grant money that fixed the problem, right?
That's from their bond, that's from their insurance bond.
Right, because they messed up the grant. With the grant money that they went down there and they prepared the thing and they paid for our grant, right?
Yes.
Okay. Then when they didn't get it done properly, it was sued to get that and to repair those things properly. So it's tied with that grant. I mean, if it's.
As far as they're here, I don't know, it's been just sitting there for 12 years.
Well, I'm no lawyer. That is grant money that they're replacing that they didn't get their job done. It wasn't even a grant, it was anything with the watershed. That's just a suit because of what was the failure because of that lawsuit.
We loaned them money.
We loaned them money?
Yes.
We got our money back. Well, like you said, why can't we spend that money? Why can't we spend that money? We got something else we need to do with that?
I believe that's the question that we asked for the attorney to be here for, is to confirm that.
So the attorney's not here, then the motion needs to be taken.
That's why I made the motion.
That's the subject of the talk.
You go further with the attorney before you make the decision. I got one more. Call the roll.
Call the vote.
Councilmember Lawrence?
No, because I want the roof fixed.
Councilmember Smith?
No.
Councilmember Henderson?
Yes.
Councilmember McDavid?
Yes.
Councilmember Byrd?
Yes.
Councilmember Porter? Mayor Pro Tim Porter?
No.
Mayor Nelson, Mayor Keever.
No.
Sorry.
Motion did not pass. Why can't you take money, a little money from both of those, each one, so you're not wiping out one or the other? If that's legal.
Don't want to know until the lawyer questions it.
It'll be a city, you know, whatever.
The only funds I know that aren't, that a city can't use, you can make any designated fund you want. But the only funds I know that you can't use the law are your hot funds and grant money that's designated or a loan that's designated by the Texas Water Board or SWIFT or one of those entities. They're having to be used for what they're for. Anything else that the city designates money for is really that's their own designation, but.
Correct.
Not attorney.
Yeah.
Where we take the money from, for me, doesn't matter. Are we entertaining a motion to fix the roof?
Let me ask a question. If we.
I would think something under the Health and Sanitation Code would apply when there's black mold in the building.
Correct.
And I'm not saying that based on the tax numbers that we have, just looking at the last 9 months, we look like we're ahead on our tax dollars. So even if we agree to do a three-year payback to whichever, whatever we decide to do, based on that, we could probably pay it back in two or less. I've always paid my debt off early. We have. I'm not saying this is going to be any different. If we borrow from one of our own funds and we're going to pay it interest, then that's no different than going to the bank for a loan. So we just need a solution.
Is there a cost for the loan, for initiating the loan?
I'm not sure.
The reason I ask that question is if we took the loan, approve it, get the roofs fixed, speak with the attorneys, figure out which funds.
We have not taken the loan.
Correct. That's what I'm saying. Take the loan. If we take the loan, fix the roof.
No, it's just a standard bank loan.
Correct, but I didn't know if there was an origination fees or closing fees.
No, those are waived for us.
Okay. At that point, do the research with the attorneys, figure out where the funds can come from, if it comes from a portion of one fund or the other. If we choose to, pay off the loan at that point, but at least our roof gets fixed and the mold stops. Go ahead and take the loan, since it's from the bank. Since there's not an origination, there's no closing costs, there's no fees to this, there's just an interest rate. After we've spoken with the attorneys to figure out which funds we can take from, if we can take it, I don't think we need a council approval to do that at that point. We may, but if we need to, we can bring it back and we can vote on it to take the funds from there, pay off the loan. But I'd hate to wait another month to fix the roofs when we have water coming in. And one of the things we're looking at too is on the loan, we're looking at a 3% interest rate.
So why don't you just encourage council to issue a legal decision, make the motion contingent upon that legal decision to take care of which fund is less than or above funds? Legal from each, as we suggested, Ralph?
I think that's what I said in the beginning when I said let's table it till you get that worked out. Not say you're not gonna fix your roof. But you still got problems regardless of which way you do it, you still gotta go out here and do some research. Things still don't hold. I mean,
that's not what Ms. Bird is asking or saying. If I'm understanding.
I'm just saying let's encourage council to issue a legal decision one way or the other as soon as possible.
I believe if I understand what you're saying, is go ahead and give permission to take the funds.
Contingent
on which fund, and approval from the council. But at that point, we're going to have to call that a meeting.
No, that's approved. We all agree that that roof needs to be repaired. There's no question about it.
Correct.
And it's actually creating a health issue if there's mold. Yeah. If it's the kind of mold that is bad. So we have to deal with it. Mm-hmm. And we need to deal with it probably yesterday. And this is the result of years of neglect and failure to maintain, which I hope we're not going to do in the future. I hope we maintain it in the future. But if this needs to be repaired and if we need to avoid any future health issues or other issues, record retention issues, etc., we need to do it immediately. So let's have our lawyer, who didn't want to be here tonight, kind of issue a decision as to whether or not we can borrow the funds from either source or both sources and borrow funds to do that. But I'm reluctant to ask for the money without having blessing from council.
I believe that's the actual.
And that's the only thing that's holding up everybody here in this council. So let's get blessing from council. Let's find out But he says unless, and I don't think we mind particularly which fund, because they're both such, so important to all of us, the water or the drainage issues. They come in and in, so long as we're repaying it, let's get it done. And if all we're waiting on is a lawyer's decision, let's get it done before the end of the week. And council can approve it subject to his approval. Does that make sense?
Mayor, you can make the motion contingent on the attorney's approval of us borrowing from ourselves and any of the funds that have been talked about to go ahead and repair the roofs. We should be able to get that from the attorney within the next day or two.
If y'all wait a minute, I'm gonna take, let's see if I can get text back.
And that's why we made the motion saying to use internal funds, not necessarily all from First Street, but from the one that you named, and if we need to, a little from First Street to make up the difference, or from even Russia Creek, if he says, yes, we could legally borrow from Russia Creek and do that. And if the attorney says yes, we can borrow.
I don't want a yes on the telephone, I want a yes in writing.
I get it from him in writing.
Okay.
But I believe he could, you know, because he can easily type an email and send it and have it in writing, or do a letter and send it in writing, or two votes.
Okay.
There's no trouble with that. I don't think it would take him that long.
Would,
because I believe he'll approve, yes, borrowing the money from within without any trouble.
And then that would alleviate Councilman Henderson's mind here, moving monies.
I guess one of my comments would be, or questions would be, would the two of you and all council feel comfortable if we split the funds between the two funds?
I feel finally we can get the roof fixed and set up. I think our problem is coming because we hadn't done our research before we got up here. First thing, we should have all these questions answered before we got here. I mean, we're still guessing about things that should have been taken care of before I took this seat right here. We ain't talking about nothing but fixing this roof. We're still talking about what a lawyer may say. It's going to be some long meetings. It's going to be some long meetings, and we're going to go crazy with this. We need to get our facts straight before we come in this door. We're coming in here talking about ifs, ands, maybes, when you should already have talked to this attorney, and we're going to make a decision without him even saying a word. Nobody want to table it, so you need to go over and talk to the man to make sure the whole city ain't going to be in trouble.
We just need
to make sure. This shouldn't have took 10 minutes. 5 minutes at the most. If every issue going to come up here like this, everybody gets about what the lawyer's going to say, we got paperwork we don't know nothing about, nobody going to give you proper advice. I'm not used to organizations that are not. Now we got to call him on the phone in a meeting to get an answer.
You should have been here.
Correct.
You should have been here at this meeting.
You should have been told.
Yes, you should have been. No, you should have been here. That's what he gets paid for.
I agree.
Hello.
That is scary.
He said he should definitely not recommend the First Street. He said Russia Creek, but yes. What he was saying was that we would just do a budget transfer from Russia Creek to the general fund and repair the roof and not worry about loan. And I just told him I didn't think that y'all would do that without getting a loan. But he's supposed to put it in.
Ms. Porter?
For tomorrow.
I'm saying y'all heard what you said. He did recommend us to mess with that First Street grant money.
Yes.
That's what he recommended.
Well, he didn't say grant money. He said not street money.
He said don't mess with it, right?
Yes.
Okay.
He did. So.
That was our problem, number one.
Okay.
And what are we going to do?
I'm like, we're back to the original problem. Are we going to use the internal phone to fix the roof?
Did y'all catch me?
I did, yes.
Okay.
Is
We can use the Russian Creek funds, but not the first.
Yes. And he said what he would do would be just a budget transfer from Russian Creek to the general fund for the roof repair without being alone. I told him that y'all would do that. And he's gonna put it all in a memo tomorrow. As a straight transfer or a loan.
Well, this council's already voted to fix the roof. I mean, that's already, that's been done many months ago, several months ago. Question is just how you go about it.
Correct. So we can get started on the roof?
You can't get started on the roof until you figure out how to pay for it. And there hasn't been how to pay for it.
So is the transfer of money from Brush Creek, or is it gonna be that we make a loan with ourselves? So basically, we end up taking a loan out on Brush Creek money to pay it back, since we're using it.
I think the thing that we're overlooking here is, if we're gonna pay back the money either way, we're talking a 3% interest rate. If we're looking at 3 years, 0%, we're talking $1,000 a year in interest is what we're deciding over if we're gonna use our money or the bank's money. If we use the bank's money, it costs us $1,000 a year. If we pay it off early, it's less.
Problem is, if you borrow money, then you have a debt service account, and then you gotta increase taxes to carry debt service.
We're actually paying off all of our debt. We will not have anything for debt service for next year.
I understand that.
But that will create one.
Well, but it's gonna hurt our tax rate if we have no debt.
Page 22.
Yep, and I believe we have a motion that has not passed to table it.
You have to make it E. But if you make it E, it may have to. Maybe we should take one to pass at this time.
So what's the story? What are we gonna do? Can we legally use Russian Creek money?
Mike Dixon just said we could.
Okay.
He said we could either do it as a transfer or loan. That should be the decision, whether you're gonna charge yourself interest or not.
When you do it as a loan, you do not have to pay interest.
It's just 0% loan to ourselves.
I've never seen a city that's done a loan where they charge any interest.
It's always interest.
And if you transfer the money from Russian Creek as not a loan, if Russian Creek ever needs money, you know what comes out of the general fund anyway. And it's gonna have to be budgeted and handled out of the general fund. So it's not,
correct,
a bad thing.
So do we have, are we entertaining a motion?
I'd say yes.
I make a motion that we use internal funds to fix the roof. How much more specific?
From which fund do you want to Russian Creek?
You could use a mixture of what he said and Russian Creek.
I make a motion that we use a mixture of internal funds to include Russian Creek to fix the roof. Are they good enough? Thank you.
I'll second.
A motion has been made and seconded. Any further discussion? Would you call for the vote?
Councilmember Warren?
Yes.
Councilmember Smith?
Yes.
Councilmember Henderson?
Yes.
Councilmember McDavid?
Yes.
Councilmember Byrd?
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Porter?
Yes.
Mayor Kiefer?
Yes.
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
Is that gonna be a loan or not?
No. Motion has passed. But at this point, we're ready to adjourn. Motion?
Make a motion that we adjourn.
Second.
We're adjourned.